Hounds, one of Donestar's recurring nightmares. Just when you had your day all planned out, they come in and ruin everything. They come in four variations. The normal hound that boasts 150 HP each, and this hound just wants to simply bite your face off. They drop a monster meat and a hound tooth upon death. Next, we have the ice hound. These variations have 100 HP and freeze any nearby enemy upon death, with a 20% chance to drop a blue gem along with the normal drops. The third variation is the firehound. These flaming critters have the same 100 HP as their chilling brothers and have the same drops, but with the exception of a red gem instead of a blue gem. Lastly, we have the horror hounds. These monstrosities emerge from the corpse of normal hounds when killed on a lunar island. Now that we know what we're dealing with, let's talk about how to deal with it. Number 1. Kiting. The first way to deal with the hounds is simply by kiting them and fighting them yourself. This tactic is first because it is the most basic and most important way to deal with hounds. This method can be used with any other method in this list. The kite pattern for the hounds is simple. Just bait out their attack and go in for 2 hits and retreat. If your ping is high or you're uncomfortable with 2 attacks, then you can do 1 attack and retreat. Their HP is low enough that this won't be a long battle regardless. If you're dealing with the fire hounds, note that the hounds will not run through fire. Instead, they will find a path around the fire, giving you more time to deal with them one at a time. Alternately, killing ice hounds will result in freezing any remaining normal hounds, allowing you to pick them off one at a time. Note that once a hound is frozen, it is no longer aggroed onto you and you are free to leave if you want. But keep in mind that they will remain in your world doing whatever they want to do until they see you again and aggro onto you once more. So it's best to take them out when you get the chance to avoid any nice surprises later. Fun fact, later in the game when the number of hounds becomes a bit too much to kite, you can use the torch as a weapon to set them ablaze and cause them to run around in a panic until the fire is extinguished over time. This will free you up to handle the not so hot dog. Number 2. Using Beefalo. Early in the game, you can use Beefalo to take out your hound nemesis. They pack a mean punch and can almost always handle the amount of hounds that come at you.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
Almost. You can even help the Beefalo out by using the kite method as mentioned before. During spring and randomly throughout the year, Beefalo enter mating season and will become aggressive towards anything that wanders into their zone, like hounds and you. When you see their butts are red, lead your hound blades around the perimeter of the spawn. Eventually, they will get too close and every beefalo in the herd will gang up on your new friend. If you are lucky enough to have a beefalo hat at this time, you can simply run straight through the center of the herd, safe from beefalo attacks, and ensure that the hound meet a swift and painful end. Ice hounds will freeze any other normal hounds, beefalo, and even you if you're within range when it dies, so be careful. Firehounds will set anything in the area on fire upon death, most commonly rot, manure, seeds, and grass, plus anything else that may be nearby and flammable. So don't leave your book bag on the ground. Number 3. The Swamp. Almost as reliable as the Beefalo, the Swamp comes in as a close contender. The reason this isn't above Beefalo is due to the fact that everything in here is ready and willing to kill you too. If you stay in the wrong place at the wrong time, you may find yourself on the receiving end of a butt weapon from a specific swamp dweller. But time it right and you can lure a hound to its spiky death with a well-placed tentacle. While you're there, you'll undoubtedly see a war occurring between spiders, tentacles, and merms, or any combination of the three. Simply lure your unwanted companion into the heart of the battle by running around it long enough for them to lose interest in you and fall victim to collateral damage. This shouldn't take long since hounds are more interested in eating stray pieces of meat off the ground, which should be present in the midst of a war. Once they eat the meat, they will have de-aggroed from you and re-aggro onto the nearest sucker in their sight. Also, this is only viable early game due to the fact that the hounds will eventually kill off any tentacles you employ and other methods are better later in the game. Number 4. Pigs. I mentioned merms, so let's talk about their cousins, the pigs. Pigs are great for dealing with hounds. Pigs are great for dealing with hounds because they will automatically target the devil dogs with little to no provocation. The reason that these are number 4 is because they are only available during 1 out of 3 phases of the day. But if the big bad wolf taught us anything, it's that we can just force them out. I'm kidding. If you want to have them stay outside, you can leave a pigskin on the ground surrounded by a barrier that the pigs can't cross, and they will mindlessly walk towards the meat morsel with the intentions of eating the booty. If you manage to have the pigs available without such tactics, all you would need to do is run around long enough for the pigs to get a good hit in. Be careful if you're followed by firehounds, because they will burn everything down to the ground, including the pig houses, if you don't have a fling-o-matic ready to extinguish the flames. Number 5. Last but not least, tooth traps. Why not use hound teeth against them with a tooth trap? Using one board, one tooth, and one rope, you can construct your very own hound killing device. The problem with this method is each tooth trap has only 10 uses and needs to be reset after being activated by the enemy. Also, the hounds have a chance of running right over top of them without activating them, or activating them without taking damage. For those reasons, I choose to never use this method, but it's an option for those who are interested. An alternate means of trapping the hounds is to use an enemy. These are free to gather and reset themselves after 1 minute and do the same damage as the tooth traps. The downside of these traps is they will go off on any target that run across them, including you. So making a safety corridor for these is highly advised. You can also pair them with tooth traps in the event the hounds make it through all the anemones, or take out the survivals with the kite method. There is no need for ice flingos for this, since anemones can't be set ablaze. Well, that was five ways to deal with hounds in the very early game with little to no resources. This is a beginner's version targeted at those. People having trouble getting past day 21 up to day 7. Well, that was five ways of dealing with hounds in a very early game with little to no resources. This is the beginner's version targeted at people who are having trouble getting past day 21 and up until day 70. I will make another list of more advanced tactics for those who have a firm grasp on the basics of the game and have amassed a surplus of resources. Tell me in the comments below what's your favorite way of dealing with these annoyances. Until next time, thank you for watching, and if you would like to see me live, come check me out on Twitch, where I'll be streaming regularly. Check out my Twitch bio for current scheduled times, and don't forget to follow for notifications. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe on this YouTube page. I really appreciate the support, and it really helps out with the analytics. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.